There are now four Democrats running for the Madison area congressional seat being vacated by Tammy Baldwin, who is running for the U.S. Senate. The newest candidate is a political newcomer, Army veteran and former U.S. Senate intern Matt Silverman. He joins a field that already includes State Representative Mark Pocan, Dane County Treasurer David Warzala, and our next guest, State Representative Kelda Helen Royce of Madison. Representative Royce, thanks very much for being with us today.
Thank you, Mike.
We had Representative Pocan on the program back a while ago, and I said, you know, it doesn't seem like there's a lot of difference in the positions on the key issues in this race. So how do you differentiate yourself in a primary?
Well, I think that, you know, we're very lucky in the 2nd District to have so many great candidates stepping forward. Certainly, I think if you look at how we would vote, it would probably be quite similar. And so really the question is about what is our approach to politics. I think there are a lot of things that make me different from your average politician. You know, certainly my background in advocacy and grassroots organizing. That's something that I think we've really moved away from as progressives. And in that vacuum, we've had tremendous corporate dominance come into our politics, huge amounts of money. We really have to get back to people-powered politics. That's something I'm very passionate about. And so I really view my job as a legislator, not just pass bills and do press releases, that's important, but my job is to help engage people in a progressive movement to help change this country and make sure that our government and our economy work for everyone.
Let's delve into a couple of things you just mentioned. The role of money in this campaign. Mm-hmm. I read a recent story where you said about politics and money that they're inseparable, but they're also insufferable. But how do you change that? Because you will obviously have mm-hmm. to raise money and probably raise a significant mm-hmm. amount in order to be elected.
Well, I think the first thing we have to do is lead by example. And I have made the commitment in this race based on what I've seen in terms of how corporate money has totally come to dominate our political system. And it's a bipartisan problem, I must say. I've made the commitment that I'm not going to take any corporate money in this race. And I think it's important that we start demanding that our politicians walk the walk and not just talk the talk. And that's true for any tough fight that we want them to take on, but in particular this. Because the way that the political system operates right now gives all the power and the credence to the super rich, the super powerful, at the expense of the rest of us. And I'm one of the very few candidates nationally that is willing to actually take that step and say, I'm going to start by being the change that I want to see.
So you wouldn't take corporate money, but what if Emily's List, the women's group, came in and said, we want to give money to support your campaign? Would that be okay?
Well, Emily's List is backing my campaign. Right. I'm very proud to have the support of one of the great groups that elects pro-choice Democratic women. But their money all comes from individuals. It's not Emily's List's money. They won't be giving me money. It's individual women and men who care about seeing a generation of leaders who are willing to fight the fight on this very tough issue.
You talked about the fact that you come from a background where you've been an advocate on a number of different mm-hmm. causes. Representative Pocan says, I have a business background. Why is a background in advocacy a better background than a background in business for the times we live in today?
Well, I think that when you look at what's happened, for instance, in Wisconsin, we're a little microcosm in terms of the tremendous attacks funded by corporate right-wing interests that put Scott Walker in office, and they're trying to roll back all kinds of rights, not just women's rights, but voting rights, access to health care for 65,000 working poor in Wisconsin, half of them children. So those kind of attacks demand a different response, not incremental change, not more kind of go along to get along, let's, you know, go over in the assembly lobby and make a deal about this. No, it demands a bold, progressive response that has been totally missing in Wisconsin. And for that, you need people. That's the only way to counter corporate power.
I have a short time left, but what is it about Congress at this moment in your life? You're only 32.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think we're really at a tipping point moment in this country, where with the Citizens United decision and the new influx of all this corporate money, the question is really, are we going to fix this economy, put it back on the right track, or are we going to continue having a system that only works for the super rich at the expense of the rest of us? And if you really want to fight that battle, you need to be at the national level.
Representative Royce, we appreciate your time today. Thanks very much for being with
us.
Next, the key numbers to watch in next year's election.
Upfront is produced with editorial assistance from WisPolitics.com, an online government and political news service.